having some issues with that. Good luck today, Edie. Good luck today, McKenna. What? Nothing. Today would be 19, if that were the case.
Yeah. We have
11
more days left.
Wow.
If we, like, go all the way under
30. Mm. Got it.
We can't
I wasn't counting today either, so I thought it would be 30.
Okay.
So don't feel bad. Okay. Any questions you have?
Number 25 on page 326.
326.
I mean
31. 31. Okay. Yeah, so on this one, we have C of X equals, this is the 2X squared minus 4X plus 3. And I want C of B squared equals 2 times B squared squared minus 4 times B squared plus 3. So my guess is you might have forgot this squared.
Yeah, I did.
Okay. So what you really got to focus on is that this is the 2 squared function. So I need the 2 b squared squared function. Okay, you're taking the x out, putting b squared in its place. Okay, and then we'll let you go from, yes?
33?
Almost. Tres y tres. Here we go. Here's 33. Okay, here's what I did. The other class asked the same question, so I thought I'd save it. So d of x is negative x to the third plus x plus 1. So d of 4y minus 3. So first thing I do is I write it out before I even start simplifying anything. One step at a time. I've learned that especially in more complicated problems, don't bite off any too much in one step, otherwise you're going to make mistakes. So here's what I did. In expanding this, I use Pascal's triangle. I'm like, let's use that information that we learned the other day. So I got 4y to the third, 4y squared, 4y, no 4y. And here I did no negative 3s, 1 negative 3, negative 3 squared, and negative 3 cubed. And then my coefficients on my cubic row are 1, 3, 3, 1. That's how I multiplied that out. So if you take a look at it, and I just did each part, I'll kind of just leave this here. And then I carried this negative out. Negatives are the biggest issue. Put it outside some brackets and distribute it when you're all done simplifying what's inside. Okay? So that might help you find out where you went wrong. And if there's any one particular term that you have issues with, let me know. How'd you get the 108? You know, or whatever.
A little on the cold side when you're sitting right here in it.
Did you do 53?
53. That one I don't have written out. Okay. So here we go. 53. Okay, I'm going to try and go through this fairly quickly. Got a dog that I get to take down to Lincoln tonight to take it to its hopefully forever home. And she's just getting to where she's really fitting in, and she's been coming up the stairs to wake me up in the morning. It's been kind of a pain, but it's been kind of cool too. 51 you said, right? Or 53?
53.
Oh, thank goodness, because 51 is a pain in the butt. Okay, so I got 5 times C of A squared minus 8D of 6 minus 3A. Okay, so I'm just going to shut up and work. Again, if there's anything where you're like, what are you doing to get that? Because maybe I made a mistake. You never know. All I'm doing is carefully looking at this, x to the third, putting in a squared in its place. Something to the third minus the 2 times that something. 4 times squared minus 6 times plus 8. So this one's not as a big a pain in the butt to multiply out. Somebody fighting out there?
Yep.
Who is it, Mrs. Dahlquist? Oh, okay. So I don't need to intervene. It's always awkward when you can hear somebody getting their butt chewed. But I don't think she does that on a large basis, so I think that's probably deserved.
She do that all the time in our class.
Yeah.
Well.
Just not outside the hall.
Yeah.
It's more of a...
I'm going to start combining some things when I can. I hope I get this right. I don't know why I turned that on. Oh, really? I hadn't thought about that. What did I do wrong? My problems are, because, you know, I'm trying to show what you guys should do if you get something wrong. So I got these two terms wrong. Okay. Is she done yet? Nope. Okay. So where's my problem? Negative 8 star, if you figure it out, come on.
Is it plus 2
come on, who's gonna get the
would
star?
It be a negative 2 because you're distributing the negative 8.
This is a negative.
And then the middle one's
negative times a negative, give me a positive.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
Right here? No. Where?
What is it,
9? Okay.
Oh, because 9 is a square.
Okay. This is making me mad. But I don't want to give up because I don't expect you guys to give up. Right here?
Yeah.
Because I plugged in 6 minus 3a for x squared.
Okay. How did you
I combined it with my 36. So negative 36 plus 8. Yeah, negative 28. So I got that. It's good. You're looking at the right stuff. That's what I want to do. Okay. 8 times 1, 44. 1152. 8 times 36. 288.
That should be 1,000, right?
Where?
The 1,152A plus 18A is plus 8.
Oh, 1170, but that's not even right. So I got a couple issues. Gosh dang it. I'll tell you what, let me work on it during homework time. I'll come back because I don't want to waste any more of your time. Okay? Okay. I hate that because we have new information I want to go over today. Okay, so here we go. There is some music that I want to listen to kind of get us in the mood today because we kind of got to be in this happy mental place here.
Just no piano music.
No harp music.
Stressful.
What?
Yeah, he plays harp music and it's
raging. Okay. So what we're going to look at today, we know that if I have f of x is x squared, we know what type of graph, we know what that looks like. Okay. It's either going to look like this, or it's going to look like this. Okay, one of the two. We know that it's going to look like this if a is positive. And we know it's going to look like this if A is negative. That's not a big deal. That's nothing revolutionary of any sort. Okay? It's just fact. What our goal is today is, what if I had AX to the third plus a lot of other stuff? What if I had AX to the fourth plus a lot of other stuff? What if I had AX to the fifth plus a lot of other stuff? I want to be able to talk about the shape of those graphs as well. Okay? Because this one, it's a parabola. No big deal. I'm going to tell you, these other ones aren't parabolas. But, you know, we need to be able to talk something about them. Okay? Okay. So here's what we're going to do. X to the third. Let's think about what's going to happen here, okay? If I take, let's assume that A is greater than zero, okay? So this is a positive number. If I take a positive number cubed, what type of number do I get? A positive number cubed.
Positive,
a big positive. Take it times A, I get a big positive. So if I have a number over here, I'm going to actually finish up here. Because as my number gets bigger, this is going to get bigger. What if I take a negative times itself three times? What do I get? A negative. So this one's going to finish down here. Okay? Hence, we'll get a graph that might look something like this. Okay? Does anybody know what type of music this is? Oh, no, it's not 80s. It is 70s. What more specific type of 70s music?
Dancing.
It is disco.
I said it first.
Oh, well, good for you. Good. Okay. So here's the deal. I call this a disco graph. Why? Okay. You betcha. So you got a picture of somebody that's really cool sitting here. They're pointing like this. They're ready to dance, man. Okay? So this I call a disco graph. Okay, why? Because disc graph go up. Starts down, but yet it goes up. Okay? So this one, A is greater than zero, it's gonna look like this. Its humps might be more pronounced, less pronounced, but it is going to have the ends like this. This is what we call its end behavior. Okay? So that's if A is greater than zero. If A is less than zero, it's gonna look something like this, going down, okay? So we have a disco up graph and a disco down graph. And I'm hoping that you realize why these are disco graphs. And the large reason is because when I take a negative to the third power, it is negative. Squaring turned everything positive. Okay? The A might turn it down, but squaring a positive gave me a positive, squaring a negative gave me a positive, and we're gonna get this. We should give this a name. What's this called?
YMCA.
Goal.
Yeah, goal.
Yeah, like touchdown, how's that?
Yeah.
Okay? So I like to call these touchdown graphs. Touchdown that goes up and touchdown down. Okay? Because you're gonna see that again. Okay? Okay, before we go on to the next one, I want to talk more specifically about how we would talk about its end behavior. The end behavior right here, it would be that my function is going to positive infinity as my x goes to positive infinity. So what does this mean? It means that as I move left on my result is increasing. So anything that's like this means that as my x gets bigger, my result also gets bigger. So how would I state it over here then? F of x, negative infinity, as x approaches negative infinity. So what that means is, on the left side of my x-axis, as my x's get bigger negatives, then my results are getting more negative. Okay? If I said something, if I wanted to talk about the red would be like this. F of x approaches what? Negative infinity. My results, f of x is my results, my y's. As x moves to the positive infinity. As x moves to the right, my graph goes down. This part up here. Disco's really not a bad music. You know, it's kind of a little different here and there, but. What? Who is this?
Disco's dead.
A disco's dead. Well, you know. Okay, here we go. Help me out. F of x approaches positive infinity because it's going up as x approaches
negative
infinity. So that's the skill we're working on today, is to describe end behavior based upon the degree of the function. Okay? While I'm here, let's talk about this real quick. Okay, how about this one? I love the nightlife. If it's x to the third, it could have two what I call local extrema, a maximum or a minimum. It could, but it doesn't have to. It could look like this. As far as x-intercepts go, it could have three of them. It could have one of them. It could have two of them. You're not quite sure. So if the degree is 3, it could have 3 x-intercepts. Could a cubic have no x-intercepts?
No.
Because it's got to go from high to low, doesn't it? Or low to high? It's got to cross that river at some point. Okay? Okay. X to the fourth. What do you think x to the fourth would look like? Just take a wild guess. If it's positive x to the fourth, what do you think? Show me with your hands. Just take a guess. Come on. It's okay to be wrong. It's okay, yeah.
How do you make it? That it's always going to be up or down.
Why?
Because it's going to be a positive.
Why is it positive?
Because when you take the negative, you're positive. So quattro it, it's going to be positive.
It's not the four. It's not that the fact the four is positive. It's the fact the four is
even.
Is that you or you? Good job. Okay. So what happens here is on any graph, if I take a positive to the fourth power, it's going to be a positive. I take a negative to the fourth power, it's going to also be positive. So I don't have that split like I do with x to the third. So it might look something like this. Okay. So I would just consider that a funky touchdown problem. Okay. When I'm talking touchdown or disco, I'm just talking about the middle part. The ends. The middle part might be like that guy's mustache on the commercial last night.
The Doritos commercial.
Yeah, that was kind of weird. It was kind of funky. I like how the horse said, uh-uh. So that would be x to the fourth. And that would be if A is positive. If A is negative, it might look something like that. Okay. It doesn't have to have like those three specific humps, but it can have three specific humps. What happens is as my degree gets larger, my graph can twist and move a little bit more. It's a little bit more pliable, if you will. A parabola, you know, you're really not much you can do with it. But like on something like this, if I've got some data that shows it increases and then kind of increases some more, I can say, that might be a quadratic or a quartic, I mean. Okay, so let's do this. F of x approaches what?
Positive
infinity. As x approaches?
Positive
infinity. Other side. F of x approaches
positive
infinity as x approaches
negative.
You know what I find really interesting? I'm just going to stop right here for just a second. This is something that my students, even as juniors, used to really, 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 really struggle with. Do you guys have any idea why you don't struggle with it now as juniors?
Because of our math curriculum is so much better.
Oh, not necessarily it's better. I would argue in some ways it's better, in some ways it's worse. But you're now being taught that you're being introduced this idea when you're freshmen. And even though it didn't totally stick when you were freshmen, I remember you guys being frustrated about it. You're like, Now, most of you guys are like, yeah, okay, that makes more sense. Okay? So on these would both be exactly the same, except would go to negative infinity and negative infinity instead. Okay? X to the fifth. Show me what you think x to the fifth would look like if a is greater than 0. Just the end behavior. What would it look like? Just the end. Don't worry about all the funky stuff between. You know, just what's the end going to look like? There you go. It's a disco up. Okay. Again, why? Because can an x to the fifth be negative?
No.
Yes, it can be negative. If I raise a positive to the fifth, I'm going to get a positive. If I raise a negative to the fifth, I'm going to get a negative. And in the middle, it's going to have more Humpty Dumpties to it. Okay. So do I need to do x to the sixth?
Nah.
Which one's it going to look like?
It's going to look touchdown.
Exactly. So what we're going to do is we're going to make some conclusions here. You know what? Rather than write it all out, I'll just show you what we came up with in the other class. So if I'm talking about I got f of x is x times a times x to the n, and all there's a bunch of other terms here I could definitely write after it, but I'm just taking about my leading term. It's a touchdown if n is even and a is greater than 0. So like 10x to the 4th, 5x to the 6th, 7x to the 10th, they're all going to be like this. Okay? Touchdown down if a is negative. That's just like a parabola, which is no big shocker because a parabola has degree 2. This is even, okay? It's a disco up if n is odd, so to the 3rd, to the 5th, to the 7th, and a is greater than 0. 5x to the 3rd. 4x to the 7th. And then it's going down if n is odd, and it's less than 0.
When would we ever use these graphs? Like in the real world?
Most of it would probably be to try and model some data. Like if I've got a situation where I expect it to be high and then come down and then maybe go back up, well then I can at least narrow it down to what type of equation might model that data. Okay? This is one of those things that I think there's even value of just looking at a pattern, making some generalizations, and then applying those generalizations. I am going to offer you some extra credit that I offer the other class as well. You're getting more homework time than them for once. If you bring me a picture of somebody like online, or I don't care how you do it, somebody doing the disco thing that emphasizes this, and then I'll give you some extra credit.
Explaining that?
No. Just showing somebody in that classic disco move. I.e. this right here.
Is this supposed to be a trick?
No, there's... if you just look up disco, it's all over the place. Why would it be a trick? Would I trick you?
Because that sounds really easy.
No, I'll give you just a little extra credit. That's
maybe
fine.
Maybe because we did bad on the quiz. Can you have assignments trying to help us out?
I have not looked at the test yet. So last time this thing stopped recording at 29 minutes and 50 seconds.
Like, not the same thing, but like, it's in the same, like...
In the same term. Okay. It's in the same term. Yes.
Okay.